Hi, my name is Joe Marchionno. I'm a conservation biologist with the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission Research Institute. Every oystercatcher pair in every oystercatcher nest is important because oystercatchers are state listed and the threats to oystercatchers are also constantly changing. This area, Pinellas County, is unique because oystercatchers have now moved from nesting on ground sites to rooftops due to the lack of availability of ground nesting sites. So the history of bird banding actually goes back to the 1920s, and it's a good way to mark individuals to better understand their status and complex life history. Oystercatcher banding has been around in Florida since 2006, and we've recently expanded our banding efforts to other parts of the state, and we're hoping that these banded individuals will help us kind of fill in a lot of those information gaps that are really important to understand the species on the population level. Now, typically for trapping and banding, adult American oyster catchers will capture the birds first and then we'll band them and also take morphometric data, and that gets put in a data repository so we can kind of understand those individuals and compare them with the population in this area and then also the general population of American oyster catchers.
Banding in an urban environment can be very challenging as it requires a lot of planning, patience, and consideration of other threats in the area, such as opportunistic predators and the presence of people. We also make sure the time a bird is in hand is limited so that we're not causing prolonged stress to the bird. The banding data will allow us to understand individual movement patterns, site fidelity, survival, and how the segment of the American oystercatcher nesting population is contributing to population recovery for the species.